Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to draw a grid that we can then use to paint into. So, like so, just paint the squares in order to get a drawing. Let's first start with that grid. And for that, you can use the line segment tool, like so, draw a line, and then double click the selection tool and then move that 4 millimeters and 0 vertical, and then click on copy. And then you can use object transform, transform again, or the shortcut command D or control D on Windows. Just hold it down to create the number of lines you want. And then you use the line tool again, and I have turned on smart guides so that it hits like so. It snaps perfectly. And then again, double click the tool, enter 0 and 4, and copy again. And again, copy like so. So that is a grid. And hold on, we're going to take a look at different methods. So I'm going to group this like so. The next method would be to use the rectangular grid tool. And when you drag this and then press the arrow to the left and arrow to the right buttons to change the number of lines, then press the shift key to draw the grid, you get a nice square with squares inside. But maybe you don't want that. And then what you can do is take the tool, click on the artboard, and enter the size of this. So maybe I want 20 by 10. This is the height and this is the width. Then I want horizontal dividers. And those horizontal dividers, they are distributed through the height. So I have to set 4 in order to get 5 rows. And for the vertical dividers, I have to set 9 in order to get 10 rows. And then you click OK. And there we have the grid, like so. We have another method. So you can start with a rectangle and then go to Object, Path, Split into Grid, and enter the number of rows and columns. Going to preview. And of course, I've just drawn a rectangle, so I don't know if that will work out. But of course, you can also make your grid like this. So let's make some more. And then like this. Okay. They are not perfect squares. So let's take a look at this in the outline view, and you see this is okay. So we have our grids that we have created. You could also use the transform effect with the line we created and then make this editable, but in the end you would need to expand the appearance anyway. So I'm going to leave it at that. In order to create, you know, to just paint into that, we can use live paint. So let's do it with this one and turn off the strokes. And then you can just take the live paint bucket tool. And the live paint bucket tool, I'm going to double click it. Turn on the cursor swatch preview so you get the swatches directly at the cursor, and then you can switch, scroll through them using the arrow keys again. So I'm going to use this orange and then just paint whatever you need to paint, like so. With this, there might be a limit to how many squares there can be, so how many lines there can be in your drawing. And if that is too many lines, then Illustrator might get very, very slow. in order to prevent that, what you can of course do is use multiple grids, like so. Just make some copies and then have multiple grids. Because the nice thing is also, you don't need to select them in order to paint. So I'm going to select another color, like so. And then Illustrator stops painting here, but then you leave the mouse and start again. So here, and press again, and then go on painting. So that's possible to have your multiple grids and paint this, like so. So whatever you need to draw in your pixel style, you can now do it easily using one of those methods to create your grid.